Smooth operator. Look who's back at it, causing all that static. It's the old Fanatic. You know, I know you guys know I'm a rock and roller, commercial rock, but I used to love that one. People are like, wow, I don't know. You just, good song's a good song. Smooth operator. But nothing for nothing. You know, that's not me. I'm, you know, I was kind of, you know, dumb when it came to the ladies, to tell you the truth, folks. I mean, I don't want to get into that. I mean, we got fires going on, or the guys are, you know what, when you hear the fire trucks, you know, that's probably a secret poker meeting for the fellas to get away from their wives. Listen, I'm going to answer a few comments, wrap things up. No, my mom is not deceased. The condolences, that's, you know, you feel sorry that she has dementia. Thank you. Condolences, she's not, I don't want you to think if I came, I came across as a implying that she is not, she's still with us. She has a severe dementia. Thank you for the concern. Again, I wish anybody had it except her, even me. And again, well, Rob, you know, oh, Fanatic. Hey, hey. Cats and dogs here, folks. It's true. I mean, they get along for the most part, but they have their moments. If you guys knew her, you would know how I feel. You know, she had a lot. She did a lot for a lot of people. Again, let's not get the set. Let's try to get the, you know, I don't want to shed no tear here. Because, you know, the last time I cried was in the movies when Bambi, when I went to the movies when Bambi's mother died. But, all right, folks. It's prom time, in matter of fact, where I'm, you know, where I'm in service to. Strange thing. Believe it or not, I didn't go to my prom. People are like, oh, a couple people, kids weren't, they're not going, so they, you know, they weren't allowed to leave early today. They got it easy these days. I didn't go to the prom. I was dating somebody younger. I don't know if it was kind of, you know, a weird situation, but whatever. I find out, you know, after me and that my girlfriend at that time broke up, one of the prettiest girls, I could have asked her. She told my sister, "Oh, how come you didn't go?" And I guess they talked about the situation. Oh, you just give her a date. I would have went with them. Yeah, thanks for telling me. I mean. Well, again, this guy was asked by two girls when I was a junior. One I knew, you know, we dated or had a fling, whatever you want to call it, in the past. And I was just like, nah, you know, I really don't want to go. And the other one was like a surprise. I'm like, I said hi to this girl, or, you know, how are you? Have a good. Never really had a conversation other than her, you know. Cordial, hi, how are you? And I was just like, oh, you, why you want to, you know, why would, you know, you go with a senior, and da, 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 da. Her friend's saying, why don't you go? You might get lucky. This guy says, nah, that's okay. See what I mean, folks? Not smooth. You know, shout out to them. I was a jerk. You know, maybe I should have went with one of them. you know, probably the one I knew, you know, just to be, you know, maybe that's why I never really stayed friendly with anyone I dated for more than, you know, more than one date. I mean, I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's just, you know, when it's over, it's over. But whatever. I know people who are like, oh, we dated, but we're friends. You know, God bless you, man. Just ain't my, you know, I mean, of course, my ex, me and her, things are a lot better. And we have two kids, so that's a different story. I mean, like I said, you know, we still have certain things, weddings, blah, blah. So we, you know, we wish each other, the best of luck, whatever, and hope everything's good and leave it at that. But everyone else, it seems weird. Like, I don't know. Again, maybe it's this guy. You never know. Again, now I'm going to astound you with things. I saw on YouTube 90 Day Fiancé, another season. Let me tell you something. This is coming from a former married man, long-term relationships, 3 or 4. Anyone that does that is just doing it for the TV show or for this. It is absolutely impossible to know exactly how you feel and be willing and to have a chance to make it work dating somebody for 90 days. I get it. They're together. They're put together. Probably for the show, but whatever. Could something happen that a spark or that's just coming together of soulmates or whatever you want to call it? Yeah, it's a 1% chance probably. Like I say, it's never going to happen, but that's all stupid stuff for the show. I mean, you know, me and the missus, we've been together forever now. No, we had things where I don't know if it's worth it, da 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 da. I knew my ex for a long time before I married her. I knew her. She went away to college, whatever. So we knew each other for a long time, and it didn't last. So, you know, that's a bunch of BS. I mean, I looked at it a little bit. I watched, like, it's on YouTube, so it's clipped. I watched about 10 minutes of it, and I was just like, you gotta be kidding me. I mean, I guess it's good for a laugh. I mean, I don't know how you people feel about it. Someone asked me in passing, who I believe is a subscriber. Then again, take a look at the shirt. Don't forget to like and subscribe. This is from Fanatic, Miss the Female Fanatic Junior and Smarty Pants. Hit it up, like and subscribe, comment down below. Commented to me in person again. Give me some feedback here. How's the aquarium in American Dream in East Rutherford? How good could it be? It's in a mall. Let me tell you something. I am an aquarium person. I like, you know, I enjoy fish. It's calming. It's enjoyable to me. If you like aquariums and you don't want to drive all the way down to Camden, I'm not saying it's as good as Camden. No, I'm not. I'm not here to bullshit you. But it's cheaper and it's right around here. It's good for what it is. I mean, it's got some cool exhibits, sharks over the head, just like Camden. It's got New Jersey and New York themes in the tanks. I think you're going to enjoy it. If you like aquariums, and it's, like I said, it's not that expensive and it's close, then you can go walk around, if you've never been, and walk around the American Dream Mall, get something to eat. it ain't bad. I enjoyed. I went twice. I went, you know, different groups of the my daughters and their significant others. We enjoyed it. Then the missus enjoyed it. She loves aquariums too. The kids love. We went to we took the girls and big boy to Camden with our other good friends that used to work with the big boy, but then not just work relationship. We are friendly with the gentleman and his wife, and they came, met us. We had a good time. So we love aquariums. We went to the one in Baltimore, Inner Harbor. That's the best one I've been to. Georgia is supposed to be the best one in the world or in the United States. Gonna get there eventually, especially now one of my daughters lives in Georgia. I mean, it's not right next to Atlanta, but we're gonna get there. Sea life is good, and here I am. I'm giving out free publicity or recommendations. Tell Sea Life, the Fanatic. Come on, let's go, Fanatic. Tell your friends. Tell an enemy. Fanatic. Never know, folks. You never know. I was watching Another Day at Rockville, and this is a lost cause, man. I can't believe that many people are going to hear that noise. And it's just, it's annoying. I mean, I'm going to say, I'm not going to say, oh my God, partially my fault. You guys know me by now. Or if you don't, it is what it is. I'm not. You know what? Again, someone asked me, and I don't know if this is a repeat message. Someone asked me, hey, if you did make it, would you really, would you want to be real famous or, real noticeable like Bon Jovi or David Lee Roth? Or would you want to be, in the background? Well, looking at it now, of course you'd want to be just, rich and have, but that's not me. That's not, of course, that's the better way to just fly under the radar. But that's not me, you're the front man. I can't see, shit, that was a Fanatic. No, they're going to be like, oh my God, she just went to the Fanatic's here. It's not even a question. Of course you'd want to be flying under the radar, but got to know who you are. That's what I'm preaching. To help myself and help you. You gotta know who you are. And again, every single day, you hear about this and that, and a kid, I want to do this, I want to do that. I don't need to learn school, I'm going to be in this sport. You gotta have a rude awakening. You are going to be really shocked how hard and minuscule the number of people make it in those kind of entertainment, sports, entertainment, movies, whatever, music. It's hard, folks. Anything else you go to school for, and if you stick your nose in there and grind, get a break. Of course, I'm not going to say you don't need a break. Luck does play in, or knowing someone. You got a chance, at least a chance, maybe a 50-50 chance, or maybe more, 60-40, whatever. Music, you got like 5 or 1%, 1 to 5%. Again, can't complain. School, what, didn't take it seriously. You can't go back in time. You don't have a crystal ball if you had it, or a time machine. The kids make me laugh, though. They think like, oh, we were just born at this age. Here you are, you're alive. Boof. They don't know that I know every trick in the book that they're trying to pull. They don't know that I wasn't no choir boy. I was bad. They don't know that I tried every slip of the, oh, I'm not here. Oh, I was here, wasn't me. You can't fool me. Plus, I worked in another school district. You never, I seen it a lot. See, I'm not going to say seen it all. I seen most of it, and I done most of it. We were kids before we were adults. That's all I got to say. And believe it or not, the vaping and the weed is getting bad. I mean, I know when I was in school, the smoking was bad. It's getting bad. And again, we took the chance. The state took the chance to make the money, legalize it. You have to be 21 to get it. Again, you get booze too, you know, even if you're not 21. You always got cigarettes. So, I mean, there's a will, there's a way, they're going to get it. I mean, you just got to hope for the best that, you know, they try it, they don't like it, or, you know, once they're of age, then, hey, I wish you wouldn't do it, you know. And again, the more you harp, the more likely you're going to do it. That's the thing. If they think that it's bothering you, some percentage of the people that, oh, I'm going to do it more, if that makes sense. So, you know, just tell me you wish you didn't do it, you know. Same with tattoos. Tattoos are everywhere. These kids are 17, 18 with tattoos. Again, there's good work out there. I'm not going to come out here. Some shit looks good. And if you like it, good. Yours truly is not a tattoo person. I've heard it forever. Oh, you were in a band. You're this, you're that. Why don't you have... It's just not my thing. And what I wanted was a lot of money. I didn't have it at the time. And I wanted it pristine. I see shit looks terrible. But again, and I don't want to get on my soapbox. If you like them, you know, some of them, I did see, you know, and I really don't like it on the ladies, but I seen a real nice flower and something dedication to the lady's mom. Look good. I mean, it is, you know, it's her thing. Looked good. Some of them look like crap. Little rose on the ankle. I mean, oh, nice work. Whatever. Ain't my thing, you know, but again, it takes all kinds to make this thing go around, bro. I mean, like you heard the smooth operator with the Fanatic. Well, yeah, good song is a good song. I just like that little sway. I just like it. I liked it since the 80s, whenever it came out, 84, 85. Something caught me. I liked it. I want to bring up something. See the conductor from Schoolhouse Rock? Hold on a second. The cats came over here and knocked down my show and tell. The Bill. Mr. Bill. My brother-in-law. He used to give me this. I hope and pray that they will. He used to say that. Oh, I used to laugh. We were having barbecues and stuff. He made me laugh big time. Shout out to Mr. Beatty Sr. there. Good times. He used to like that shit. That shit was funny, man. But it was learning and it was funny. I used to love that. I love the conductor, Conjunction Junction. I had the shirt. You know, I used to wear, when I used to perform, I used to wear a lot of, you know, a nice shirt over it, a dress shirt or a vest or a jacket. Underneath that with Conjunction Junction, what's your function on the back. And I wore, I put on a fashion show for you folks. And you know what? When I see someone that's just standing up there, t-shirt, you know, white t-shirt, or, you're not playing the part. I mean, I want the whole nine. I want the outfit. I want the, you know, again, it's me. It's me. It's the Fanatic, you see. Me here, you there. All those kinds of bullshit, you know. You know where you're at. And you found me. Or you came back. You're waiting for the next proclamation of the Knucklehead Fanatic. I'm here for you, folks. I'm here for you. Yeah, so another thing. The Planet of the Apes had a short-lived TV series. It's hard to find, but that's good, too. I really enjoy it. I have it on DVD. Again, the missus gets, you know, like I said, we got DVDs and CDs coming out. You know what? The weekend's coming up. The weather's still crap. UFL, Sunday's matchups are a little bit more important. The other ones are, you know, if you like football, put them on. The big fight, Usyk and Fury. I got to go with Fury. He's too big. I think he's too big, too strong for him. If he's not ready, this guy's sneaky. This guy, I didn't think this guy could beat Joshua either, but he did twice. So, should be a good fight if you want, you know. I mean, it's a lot of money, but if you, you know, there's other ways around it. You guys know. You ain't stupid. You're on this channel, you ain't definitely ain't stupid. You enjoy this channel, you ain't stupid. You know, if you are, don't stay here. Stay stupid. I don't know, whatever. Stick with this Fanatic. Stallions are 7-0. 8-0, 9-0. They might lose the last game. And again, they're set with the situation with their first round matchup in the playoffs. Maybe they should lose. But then again, competitors never want to lose. But I wouldn't want to risk it. I want everybody healthy for the real game. But I think they're gonna go 10-0. But if they do lose, it probably will be in week 10. Because that's the opponents 2 weeks in a row. You don't want to show them nothing. But again, the league's small, so that, you know, it's kind of takes the drama out of it. But Sunday, St. Louis and D.C. are having a rematch. St. Louis really took it to the defenders, D.C. defenders. That's on 12 o'clock, I believe, either on ABC or Fox Sunday. Check that one out if you're not doing nothing. And there's another game at 4 that's has some playoff implications. And it's the Rocks team, my least favorite team in the league, the Brahmas. But whatever, they're in the playoff hunt, so give it a shot. I mean, what are you waiting for? It's almost over. Give it a shot. The schedule came out. You know, it's a bunch of Jets got a bunch of primetime games. You know, that's good for the people home who don't have the ticket, so they don't have to watch that shit every week. You know, it is what it is. I'm here for you. I'm looking out for you. The only person you're destined to be is the person you decide to be. Take that, stew on it, and please always remember and never forget. Opinions, except for mine, are like, enjoy the weekend, hope for the better weather. See you on the next go around.